We are LT. That's quite a statement to make about a school with over 4,700 students and spread out over two campuses. A great deal goes on here at Lyons Township High School each year, a lot we take for granted. Music, dramatics, athletics, student government, even the chimes we hear every day. But they are just a part of what makes LT great. Just think of what has happened during these past 9 months. Football, homecoming 1944, the dedication of our new stadium, and Christmas. Who could forget Christmas? Student council decorations, the Christmas formal, and Vespers. Remember the choir? There is much to remember. Theater Board served up such dramatic successes as Enter Laughing, Julius Caesar, Girl Crazy, and Tartuffe.
Madam, forget the man. Each day he grows more gullible. One can lead him about by the nose. To see us here would fill him with delight, and if he saw the worst, he'd doubt his sight.
Nevertheless, do step out for a minute into the hall and see if there's no one in it.
Man's a perfect monster! I must admit, I'm simply stunned. I can't get over it.
Are you coming out so soon? How premature to get back in hiding, waiting till you're sure. Stay to the end, be convinced completely. We mustn't stop to think that proof concretely.
Hell never harbored anything so vicious!
Oh, Todd, don't be hasty. Try to be judicious. Wait and be certain that there's no mistake. No jumping to conclusions now, for heaven's sake.
Ha ha ha!
I've given the neighboring rooms a full inspection. No one's about. And now I may at last...
Hold on, my passionate fellow! Not so fast!
I should advise a little more restraint. Oh, so you thought you'd fool me, my dear Sage. How soon you wearied of a saintly life, wedding my daughter and coveting my wife. I've long suspected you, and had a feeling it soon I'd catch you at your double dealing. Just now you've given me evidence galore. It's quite enough. I have no wish for more.
I'm sorry to intrude you so slyly, but circumstances force me to be wily.
Brother, you can't...
No say. More talk from you! Just leave this household without more ado.
What I intended...
That seems fairly clear.
Burn your falsehoods and get out of here!
No. I'm the master here, and you're the one to go. This house belongs to me, I'll have you know. And I'll show you that you can't hurt me by this contemptible conspiracy, that those who cross me know not what they do, and that I've means to expose and punish you, avenge offended heaven, and make you grieve that ever you dared order me to leave.
Dear God, I'm worried. This is no laughing matter.
How so?
I fear I understood his drift. I'm dreadfully distressed about the deed of gift.
You gave
him? Yes, it's all been drawn and signed. But one thing more is weighing on my mind.
What's that?
I'll tell you. But first we'll see if there's a certain strong box in his room upstairs.
The Chorale Show was a major highlight of the year, which everyone, as always, looked forward to. Completely student-produced, Wooden You was a takeoff on Pinocchio.
Thank you.
This year, LT lost a good friend. Mr. Diebler, former principal, retired to sunny Florida.
I must say two things which recognize that, after so many years, the school itself has become one's very life. The first is to thank the school, and this includes the students themselves over the many years, my colleagues on the teaching and administrative staffs, the administration, the Board of Education, and the parents of the district for the wonderful opportunities given me during my professional career. I must say thank you for all of these things, and I mean it very deeply. The second thing I must say is that while the past of LT has been glorious, my firm belief is that the really golden years of the school are ahead. And these give you, as students and faculty, a thrilling challenge for the future. So it is not goodbye to LT for me. It is rather my very best wishes and happy anticipation for an even more brilliant LT in the days ahead.
School was over a week early this year. The school building fell silent. Well, almost silent. Every once in a while, the sounds of a hammer hammering pierced the air. The construction neared completion. We'd begun to use the new facilities. In January, we dedicated the biggest project of construction, the field house.
Ladies and gentlemen, and fellow students, it is a distinct pleasure for me to appear before you as a representative of the Board of Trustees of District 204 to dedicate this new Lyons Township High School Spectator Gymnasium to the development of healthy young people in our high school and the pleasure of our citizens, whose overwhelming support has made this new physical education complex possible here at North Campus. We hope our students benefit from these new facilities and the citizens enjoy them. And I think if the basketball game that we started off with tonight was any indication, this place isn't going to be big enough to hold us all from now on in.
In sports, the spring teams had their perennial battle with the weathermen, but each varsity squad managed to excel in conference play.
Lyons varsity baseball team has been very good in the past two or three years. They've taken first place. This year, the team has done very well, and they're leading the league with hitters as Bill Bauer, Cliff Halpin, and Jim Spina. The team looks as though they're going to go downstate. They've got a real good chance, and their star pitcher with Nat Gilbert. The tennis squad now, led by Tom Cooey, beat Hinsdale Central, the defending state champions, to win the district title. The golf team beat such powers as RB and York to have a 4-1 overall record. And the Tracksters took second in both the Maine and Hinsdale relays.
No matter what memories linger from your days at LT, you'll never forget the sports events. Remember dry, crackling leaves, the crisp chill in the air, and football.
Lyons Township 1968 team had an overall record of 5-3 overall and 5-2 in conference. That was good for third place in the West Suburban Conference.
Some of the outstanding players we felt were Tom Thompson at quarterback, Jim Spinn at halfback, Larry Krebs and Tom Tools at ends, and Cliff Harper at tackle. These were all conference players. Some of the others were Dennis Peters, Joe Murnick, and Jim Cooley.
This year we got to play on a brand new field. It was initiated Bennett Stadium in October, and we played Proviso West for that game. We beat Proviso West 35-7.
Our next game we played Riverside Brookfield, and we beat them 20-0, our only shutout of the year. The last game of the season, we fought, was the highlight of the year. We beat Donner's Grove North in the last 20 seconds on a touchdown pass from Thompson to Krebs. We beat them by 1 point to clinch third place in the conference.
And who could forget the fantastic record set by our great basketball team? After a successful season, Scott Keeve reminisces about their efforts.
I think the most memorable was doing as good as we did in the Christmas tournament at Proviso West. We were surely delighted at our second place finish, and although unhappy that we didn't beat Proviso East, however, we were quite satisfied, and this is one of our high points of the year.
Did you think that overall it was a successful season?
Oh yes, we had a highly successful season, as our record points out. We had a 21-6 record, and we beat such teams as Thornton and Holman Flossmoor. We just missed out against IRB and New Trier, and we had a little bad luck with Proviso East. But overall, I think we had a real fine season. I think the main turning point was right after the Christmas tournament. We started to gel as a team. We put together a stable offense, and we started to put together a string of victories, which we had throughout the rest of the year, against only two defeats, I think. And we had a pretty successful season after the Christmas. I think the school support, school spirit that LT has is tremendous. It helps the team 100%. It does great things for you when you're out on the basketball floor, when you're playing out there, you hear the crowd. It just helps you tremendously. You hear the students behind you, the way the kids are at LT. It's just tremendous.
Tremendous is the only way to describe the team's work in the Argo game. Here are parts of it, including the third and fourth quarters and that miraculous overtime.
Jump ball goes to Keith. He shoots. No good. Got Keith. Can't seem to get rid of the ball. Now the ball's thrown all the way the length of the court to Richardson. Richardson driving. Shoots. No good. Rebound taken by Shaw. Over to Abraham. Under to Abraham now. Back to Keith. Keith turns around. Shoots. Scores. 47-32. That's Keith's 7th point. Ball taken down now by Ellens. Shaw pounding him. Doolittle now with the ball. All the way into Bailey. Bailey underneath to Mallory. Mallory now looking. Throws it to... And foul now called on number 54, Dan Litwicki. And Richardson goes to the line shooting 2. Richardson has... Ken Litwicki has only 1 foul now. Richardson has 6 points for the evening, and his free throw is no good. 47-32 is the score. Lions down by 15 big points with 1:56 left in this third quarter. It's going to take quite a game by their team to get back in this. Sargo eating up time. They have the ball. They get the ball out, and they lose it. They didn't get that shot. 66 seconds left. LT with a chance to pull it in one basket. 68 seconds left. As they stall, didn't work for Argo. Washington with the ball. Dribbling, trying to get across the 10-second line. Finally does. Drives all the way under. Puts a shot up. No good. Ball busts around. Keep with the ball. Puts a shot up. No good. The whistle had blown. And picking up the foul is number 25, Lynn Bailey for Argo. 55 seconds left in the game. Timeout is called by Argo. 55 seconds remain. There's a buzzer for the final 55 seconds of action. Don't go away, folks. 55 seconds. 4 points. Can LT finally close that 4-point gap that they've been unable to come within all this first quarter? At the line, Scott Keeve with probably the biggest free throws of his career. Will he have the 1-1 or the 2-1 shot foul? Either way, we'll have the chance to get the 2. It is a 2-shot foul, but we need both of them. Keeve bouncing the ball. It's up. and no good. That could be a big miss. We'll need two baskets to win it. All right, Keeve with another shot. We'll need this one too. Argo with his 4-point lead, 60-56. This shot up, and it's no good. Having the rebound though, Rick Abraham. He shoots, and it's good! 50 seconds remain. Throwing the ball in is Ellens. He can't find anybody. Finally, he gets it out. And feed the ball to Washington. Washington over to Bauer. Bauer's going to shoot. Bauer, off by him. 30 seconds left in the game. Throwing the ball in is Ellens. He gets it to Mallory. Scores all tied up. Gets the ball to Bailey. Bailey over to Ellens. 18 seconds left. We can't foul now. 14 seconds. 13, 12, ball over in the corner. Pass under. And 3 seconds in the lead! 3 seconds in the lead! 7 seconds left! Timeout is called by LT! It'll be at least an overtime! 93 seconds left. And picking up the foul is Scott Key. Lynn Bailey at the line with possibly the biggest free throws of his high school career. He'll have the 1-1. The score all tied up, 62 all. 92 seconds left in overtime. Free throw is good, 63-62. 92 seconds left. He's got a second rebound. That's 26 points for Bailey tonight. Out and out, the biggest scorer on both teams. Second free throw up, and it's good. 64-62, LT gonna have to come down and score again. Washington, Bauer. Bauer, dribbling, gets it to Shaw. Shaw has it taken away from him now. Then it's taken away from Ellens. Washington to Abraham. Abraham shot, it's good! Tied up, 64 all. Abraham scoring his second basket in the overtime. Ball over to Richardson. Richardson looking pass. Finally gets it over to Bailey. Bailey at the free throw line. The shot is blocked. Ball comes out to LT. Key puts up the layup. No good. Just when we needed it. Score still tied with 51 seconds left. Timeout is called by Argo. Ball brought in by Argo. With the ball is Jackson. Gets it over to Bailey. Bailey back to Jackson. Will they wait for a final shot? There are 42 seconds left. With the ball is Ellens. And they waited too long. A jump ball will be called. LT getting a chance now. Another break for LT. Shaw, or Scott Key will jump. It'll be Marcus Washington, who is at least 4 inches taller. Tip up, goes to LT. LT with the ball now. Key with the ball. Key to Bauer. Bauer, Washington, 30 seconds left. Shaw with the ball. Shaw. Over to Washington, 22 seconds left. Shaw to Washington. Washington back to Shaw. Over to Keeve. Keeve in the near side. Gets it into Washington to Bauer. And a foul is called with 14 seconds left. And number 43, that's Richardson. Marcus with the 1-1. A chance to put LT up by two. And it's good! Still with 14 seconds left. 14 seconds left. Washington. Free throw up, and it's good! Time clicking now, 13, 12, with the ball is number 15, Jackson, over in the corner to Scott. Scott, oh! Shot is blocked, LT with the ball now. It goes down, and it'll win! 66-64 in overtime!
LT can certainly be proud of its athletic teams, but it can be just as proud of its student government. One of the things that the student council did for the student body was to revise the dress code. Here's Bob Van Nest to tell us of other accomplishments of the 1968-1969 school year.
For 10 years, the conception has built up that student council is a clique, a group that doesn't truly represent the majority of students. What we've attempted to do this year, then, is listen to what the students had to say listen to what complaints they had, and try to pattern our council year around some of their gripes, some of their ideas. Now, the word listening and the word communication are both overused words in student council work. So we've got to kind of define what we mean. We can talk about personal listening, where we ask our student council members to be attentive in the halls, attentive in classes. We can talk about organized listening, where we set up various times and schedules for gripe-ins. We have concentrated on the latter, as most of the students will profess some of the gripe-ins, particularly at South Campus, were highly successful this year. We set up specific times where kids could come in and air their gripes. We also tried to attack the problem of the mess that we find in halls both at North and South Campus. South Campus particularly was noted for its messy cafeterias. So through a series of poster campaigns and also oral reminders during comm periods, we think we've alleviated some of the problems at South. We hope that both our work in the cafeterias and our work through the seminars will be carried on in the future to provide students with a greater voice in their student government. By the same token, I feel very pleased that student council has had great support from the student body. Our efforts to arouse school spirit, both in the football and the basketball seasons, were well received. I think this year, most of us noticed a marked increase in student participation, particularly at athletic events.
As the school year drew to a close, our foreign students, Katrina and Fernando, expressed the sentiments of many of the seniors in their farewell speeches to the school.
And I tell you, I will never forget this school, this people, and this country. And Elsie is always going to remain as my school. And to all the seniors, I want to say that if we don't meet each other before, in 25 years, in homecoming, we will all meet here again. Thank you.
Next, that singing hot dog from Guatemala, Fernando. Adios, amigos.